Welcome to Southern Spain. We're just down the road from Almeria and we're here with Triumph to test their new 1050 Speed Triple RS. This new bike for 2018 obviously makes it Euro 4 compatible. Let's start with the chassis. Well, the frame, the forks, the shock, the dimensions, the swinging arm, the rake, the trail, the wheelbase is all the same as 2017. The brakes and the calipers were the same as 2017. However, there is slightly different pads, but it's 2017 essentially. Basically, the recipe was good already, so why improve on a proven package? What is big and what is different is the first is the engine. The engine is 7% more power, 4% more torque. So we're just shy of 150 horsepower of peak power. They've done a lot of changes to the engine, improved the fueling, airbox, the compression ratio, the crank inertia they've changed, and the exhaust is now free flowing. This is the RS model. So this comes complete with the Arrow exhaust, which is a massive weight saving. And because they've saved weight off the back, it's like removing panniers almost off a sports touring bike. Quoted weight, dry weight, is down 3 kilograms from the 2017 model. Another new upgrade is the new TFT dash, which is a similar kind of dash that you'll see on the Tiger, both the 800 and the 1200. On the RS, we have 5 rider modes, including a specific track mode. It's full color. You've got 6 different layouts, 6 different options. It's all done by the backlit switch gear, which is all new. While we're talking about the switch gear, heated grips, because this is the RS, 3-way heated grips come as standard. And you've got the little joystick to get to navigate around the clocks. Again, as this is the RS, you get the carbon accessories, and it's just really nice finish, real nice little details that really make the bike really stand out. But the bit you cannot see is the IMU. Now that's the internal measurement unit, which measures lean angle, pitch and yaw. So the old 2017 model didn't have that. So it had conventional ABS, which means when you applied the front brake and the back brake, it measured the wheel speed, and then when it noticed the difference, it cut in. Same with the traction. Now we're measuring lean angle, so we've got cornering ABS, and the traction control allows to compensate for lean. So it's a big step up from the old model. But unfortunately, on the standard S model, you don't get that. The S model is 11350. This is the RS, which will be 13250. So we've had like a couple of days riding the bike. On the road, it is everything what the old bike was. It's really smooth, it's got loads of power, the torque is so flat, so linear. It's really easy to ride. On the switchback mountain roads that we've had here, it's been an absolute joy. It's really smooth and forgiving. The suspension, even though it's very factory all-in suspension and it is very racy, it's still plushy enough to give you support. You're not riding a race bike that simply had its fairings removed. Really nice, really good quality, ride quality. And we've also been to Almeria, where we got the chance to test the bike on track. There's a specific track riding mode, which interestingly gives you conventional ABS, so that removes the cornering ABS and allows 50% slip on the rear. On track, again, it was such an easy bike to ride. And I really think that some sports bike riders who are kind of in the middle group or towards the fast group of a track day would actually go quicker on an easy to ride, comfortable naked bike like this. Obviously, if you find this power intimidating, you can flick into the road mode on track, which does give you cornering ABS and lots of traction control and lots of safety. In the wet, which we've had today, unfortunately, there's a specific wet mode. We got the chance to ride the bike in the wet on track with the Pirelli Supercoursers, which may sound a bit crazy, but again, it showed how great the cornering ABS was and the traction. You could feel it playing and saving you, which meant you could ride around Almeria in relative safety in the rain mode, which limits the horsepower to 100 HP. So in summary, overall, when you look at the bike, there's not massive changes. The chassis is the same, the suspension is the same, the brakes are the same. They've saved a bit of weight by removing the exhaust. And if it was going to be really brutal, you could get the old model, fit the new exhaust, and you'd have something similar or thereabouts. However, what you would miss is the new IMU with the new cornering ABS and the new cornering traction control. The engine spins up quicker, it has 1,000 more RPM. The less inertia on the crank makes the bike steer a lot different. It's much more precise and easy to manage. So it's all these little improvements have made quite a step for the 1050. But again, the old bike was such a good bike, it was really difficult for Triumph to make such a massive leap forward because the old bike was so good. If you're going to take one for a test drive in the UK, take your wallet, because I reckon you'll buy one.